Just want to come and love on you and read the word to you and talk to you guys about some stuff. I just want to apologize for not being on the last couple days. I haven't felt 100%. I've really been fighting through some things, but praise God, I still don't feel 100%, but I am going to come on here and do this for you guys. This is John 13, 5. It says, he poured water into a basin and began to wash the feet, the disciples' feet, and to wipe them with a towel, which he was girded. So again, this is John 13 and 5. It says, he poured water into a basin and began to wash the disciples' feet and to wipe them with the towel with which he was girded. And that was the New King James Version. Okay, and actually I'm going to read. This is called Daily Splashes of Joy. And I actually read this last night. And this just really ministered to me. And I want to share this with you guys. It says, if we were royal heirs to an earthly monarch, we might have this grand attention-getting duties such as leading military campaigns or reigning over lavish ceremonial affairs. Instead, we are heirs to a servant king who we honor by serving others in humility and in love. Listen to that. I'm going to read that part again. It says, instead, we are heirs to a servant king, which is King Jesus, who we honor by serving others in humility and love. Our duty here may be something simple and even more important. It says, to speak a healing word to a broken heart, to extend a hand to one who has fallen, to give a smile to those whose laughter has been lost, to encourage the dreamer who has given up, to ease the burden of one bent low beneath a thankless task, to reassure the doubter and reinforce the believer, to light the candle of God's word in the midst of another's darkest night. Kindness is love in work. Close. I love that. Listen to that again. It says, kindness is love in work. Close. I mean, how beautiful is that? And I want to tell you guys a little quick story, and then I want to read a part out of The Cry of the Spirit. This is a Smith Wigglesworth. And anyway, today I had some errands to run. I had to do some things. And I walked by this lady that was on a bench sitting. And when I walked by her, you know, the Spirit of God just spoke to my heart. And I got further away, and I went to my car, and I looked back, and I knew that God wanted me to go tell her something. And I'll be completely honest, I didn't feel good, and I felt really cruddy, actually, and I did not feel in my natural body to go back over there and to say anything. But I knew in that moment, I know when the Holy Spirit speaks to me, and I knew in that moment that I had a choice to be obedient or not be obedient. And I chose to be obedient. So as I turned around to go back over there, she actually had got up from the bench. And in my heart, I thought, oh God, please don't let her leave, because I did not want to be disobedient. So she got up from the bench and started walking towards me. And the only reason I'm sharing this with you guys, because I really, truly, honestly want to be as transparent as I can be and just let you guys know what obedience looks like or what listening to the Holy Spirit looks like. It wasn't like the sky opened and I heard a voice and, you know, that God said, angel, I want you to go say this. It's that still small voice inside of our hearts. And so I walked over to her, and I told her, I said, excuse me, ma'am. I said, when I walked by you, I said, the Holy Spirit spoke to my heart and told me to tell you. I said, I don't know what this is going to mean to you or why, but that your life has value and purpose and that Jesus loves you. And this is the thing, you guys, we don't have to know, and I'm talking to myself just as much as you guys, we don't have to know why God tells us to say what he does to someone. I don't know what she was contemplating or feeling in that moment, but she, and I'm a hugger anyway, so when I said that to her, I just reached out and gave her a hug and said, Jesus loves you, and she just looked at me so sincere and just said, thank you. And I walked away because he didn't tell me to do anything else or say anything else. And I walked away, and as I went to my car, I seen her in my rearview mirror. And I could see her looking at me, you know, looking at my car as I got in my car and I drove away. And I just continue to pray for her, because I could just say this. I'm so thankful that God loves us enough to reach down in the state that we're in the place that we're in the condition that we're in, and continue to pour his love on us. You guys, Jesus is crying out. He wants our love. The devil has lied to so many people for so long that they don't even feel worthy of the love of God. They don't even feel worthy that this holy, righteous Jesus would love them, because too many churches have just been so ratchet for so long. And I'm saying churches as a whole, that the body of Christ has just been so judgmental and condemning to so many people that people don't even feel worthy of the love of God, because churches aren't open and accepting, and people aren't open and accepting. We are not the judge of anyone. Only God can judge us. And that's why there's so much diversity and division and strife, and there's so much heartache and pain around the world today. It's because people quit walking in the love of Christ. They quit walking and loving one another and bearing one another's burdens and saying, hey, I'm here for you. Yeah, you messed up. Yeah, you know what? You might have made a horrible decision in your life. Yeah, you might have been out there in the pig pen and rolled around and got so filthy. But you know what? We're supposed to be like that good Samaritan and reach out our hand to those that are out and those that have fallen in that pig pen. Now, granted, it's a free will. Some people want to stay in that, and they don't want help. They don't want to be delivered. They have a free will, and they choose to remain in that. That's one thing. But you know, when people fall down and they realize what they've done, are we going to be the hands and feet of Jesus? Are we going to reach in the fire and pull those out that want to be pulled out? Or are we going to stand there and look down and say, you should just burn. You shouldn't have did what you did. God have mercy. God have mercy on us if we do not extend grace and mercy and love and forgiveness to those around, because we've become so religious, or we've become so self-righteous, that we're no longer being the voice of God, helping the hurting, going to the least of these. You know, nobody willingly just wakes up one day and says, you know, I think I'm going to be a prostitute today. Or, you know, I think I'm going to be a homeless. Or, you know, I think I'm going to go commit a crime and go to prison. Or, I mean, people just don't do that. And, you know, we have to be there for the least of these. So I just... I'm not even going to read that. You know, guys, I just pray that each and every person tonight, that we really just bring our hearts before God. And I believe that this is a time of healing and restoration, and that God wants to heal relationships and families. And God wants to restore people, which means to be brought back to its original state. And God wants to mend broken hearts. You guys, this is the year of Jubilee. Debts are canceled. Hearts are mended. Prisoners are let out. you know, it says captives are set free, you know. I mean, it goes on and on and on and lists what the year of Jubilee is. But you guys, we play a role in that. You know, everything is not the devil. We can't blame everything on the devil. You know, we have to take responsibility for our actions and how we treat people, you know. And I love this little thing right here. I love this. Of course, I love anything that says love because I love to love. And I think love is the most beautiful gift. It wasn't the nails that nailed Jesus to the cross. It was the love he had for us, that he looked 2,000 years down the road and he's seen all of us. And he said, even when we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. Thank you, Jesus, for that. But you guys, look at this. It says love. And it says spice for living, immeasurable. I love that. I mean, it says, and then on the ingredients, it says faithfulness, gentleness, goodness, joy, kindness, patience, peace, perseverance, protection, trust, truthfulness, and unselfishness, which is the fruit of the Spirit. So I just think this is so beautiful. Just a little reminder that, you know what, wherever we are and whatever we do, you don't know what people are going through. You don't know the life that people have lived. You don't know the heartache they live with. You don't know the demons that they battle. None of us do. We all battle things. We all yeah, some people might come from a darn near perfect family, and maybe your mom and dad got it going on, and you have a me, my four, and no more attitude, and you have a great little perfect family and a life, but that's not the story for most of us. Most of us come from dysfunctional families that have tried to do the best they could with what they had, and you guys, we have to just forgive people. We have to extend mercy, and you know what? We have to step out of our little stupid comfort zones. We have to step out of our comfort zone if we are going to be effective in these last days. We have to step out of our comfort zone. I mean, was it really comfortable for me to go over and say that to that lady? I mean, honestly, no. Not initially. But I'm so grateful that I did obey the Holy Spirit, because I don't know what that woman was going through. I don't know where her state of mind was at the time. Yeah, she looked pretty. She had her hair colored and she had makeup on and, she was dressed nice and all that other stuff. But I don't know what she was dealing with. So I just pray that you guys hear the heart of God tonight, because I've really been in prayer, you know, about what to say and to come on here. And I really just know in my heart that this is the heart of God, because I love what he loves and I hate what he hates. And I want to always be sensitive to his spirit and whatever's on his heart. So Lord, I just pray for each and every person tonight, God. I just pray that you will minister to each and every one of us. I pray, God, where there's things going on in our families and our situations and our lives, God, I just pray that you would work on the behalf of every situation and every circumstance as only you can. Lift the brokenhearted, touch those of us that are fighting infirmities, God, touch those that are battling in their minds and their hearts and their emotions and their walk with you. God, those that are struggling in ways that they can't tell anyone, God, Lord, touch those that feel alone in their walk with you. And maybe they are physically alone because their family or friends, or they don't have any. God, comfort them and hold them and love them. God, be with those tonight, the least of these. God, be with the least of these tonight. God, be with the orphans. God, be with the widows. Be with those that are incarcerated. God, be with our brother and sisters in Christ that are persecuted because they love you. God, be with those. Cover them with the blood of Jesus. Minister to them and wrap your arms of love around them in Jesus' name. You guys, we have got to step out of our comfort zone like never before. If we're going to do the great things that we've shouted and preached on and we've been taught and all this, we have to step out of our comfort zone and we have to care about other people. We have to care about the needs of other people. We have to care about the broken hearts of other people. This is not the same generation that our grandparents had. It's going to take a lot of work. It's going to take being compassionate. It's going to take walking in the love of Christ. So I just pray that people are stirred to live and love like never before. I love you guys, and God loves you.